George Zimmerman speaking out in his first television interview since the shooting of Trayvon Martin in February. It is the first time we are hearing Zimmerman's account of the killing. The big question now, will it help or hurt his defense? ABC's Matt Gutman starts us off.
In his first TV interview, a stunning admission from George Zimmerman.
Is there anything you regret? Do you regret getting out of the car to follow Trayvon that night?
No, sir.
Do you regret that you had a gun that night?
No, sir.
Saying the deadly shooting was fated.
I feel that it was all God's plan, and for me to second guess it or judge it.
Is there anything you might do differently in retrospect now that time has passed a little bit?
No, sir.
At the end of his interview with Fox News' Sean Hannity, Zimmerman changes tack, turning to the camera.
But I do wish that there was something, anything I could have done that wouldn't have put me in the position where I had to take his life.
But after this reenactment of the shooting in March, Sanford police stated Zimmerman could have avoided it all, had he only identified himself or followed police instructions to stay in his vehicle. During the interview, Zimmerman seemed relatively at ease, even smiling, assuring Hannity this part of his call to police was not a racist remark.
Punks.
It was not a racial epithet of any type.
He then describes his first interaction with the 17-year-old Trayvon Martin that tragic night in February.
He asked me what my problem was.
Expletive problem.
I was shocked. I looked up and he punched me and broke my nose.
One shot.
And then the fight.
He started bashing my head into the concrete sidewalk.
Zimmerman says when he shot Martin, he thought he missed.
I didn't think I hit him.
Martin died almost instantly. Zimmerman had previously apologized to the Martin family in court on April 20th, but he did it again last night.
I am sorry that they buried their child. I can't imagine what it must feel like, and I pray for them daily.
Now, I spoke with the Martin family last night, and they said they were overcome with emotion, especially painful for them, George, was when Zimmerman said that this was all part of God's plan. Tracy Martin, Trayvon's father, said they must worship different gods because his God did not want his teenage son to have been killed that night.